Oh, internet. It's another drawing session working on acknowledgements. It's a story for Letters of Montreal. And I just picked up an album from an old friend, Michelle Breslin, Lost World, Standing Perfectly Still. Interested in the music I'm playing, I'm checking out an album by an old friend of mine, Michelle Breslin. I'll post the Bandcamp link in the chat. Should buy it if you like it. Nice ambient, spooky stuff. You guys actually hear the music when I play it in my studio. I suspect there's a lot of compression. Kind of sounds like it right now. I'm just assessing what I got done yesterday. That's what that said. This is a scene of a class I taught, which I have a reference for. Last summer, if I recall. Or fall? Last fall? One of those. Thank you. So looking over scripts last night, thinking about how to handle Mind Engine with postponing it, like whether I should do like more issues. I have a currently planned I was going to relaunch in May, but I'm postponing. I already decided that. What's the page count again now? I think I want to say almost 60 or just over 60 pages when you include things like notes and little bits of interstitia that have to be added. Like for the installment of Dream Life, it's book 2, so I was going to do a previously seen type thing, summarizing book 1, bring you up to speed so you don't necessarily have read it to enjoy the contents. And it'll have a nice little... I was going to put 2 pages aside for that, because I was going to include a little ad for book 1 on the facing page. Seemed reasonable. If you like this, you might want the first part. And then... you know, stuff like that. This would be a forward index. So now, I'm leaning towards maybe doing more than one book before I start launching them. That's actually not that's always a traditional thing to do for ongoing serials. So it wouldn't entirely be a bad idea. But I was also just thinking about how I could just make it a bigger book. And I looked at compromises I'd made in terms of for serializing. Are there better places I could be breaking the stories? I would just add a few more pages to them. There are 3 stories that are definitively serialized. Technically, also the Bastard's Tale stuff is my memoir. But I'm not doing those as a series you have to read in a particular order. They're a bunch of little short anecdotal stories about my childhood, so they don't have a traditional serialization structure. They're a bunch of stunning ones. That's so in Mind Engine of the Box, which is a reworking, reimagining of the Tinderbox, the Hans Christian Andersen children's fairy tale. Well, we assume children's anyway. It's pretty dark, which is kind of why I like it. And I've turned it into a weird Cthulhu fairy tale. I'm partly inspired by things like Dark Crystal. And that's... I have done 8 pages, which is like the first little bit. And that was going to be the first entry. And I was keeping them in like short little chapters for that one, because I like the fairy tale feel. I might do like the second chapter, do 2 chapters. And that's kind of fun because I can use it. It's with the anthology conventions that I kind of liked, although some people didn't, in heavy metal, was how they would break stories up and have them run in chunks with intermissions for articles and other comics. So I might do that with the box, make a second installment. Dream Life, I think there are at least two places I could cut it differently for part of or the entirety of the first act. If I do the whole first act, it goes from being pretty short first entry to a 42 page, like the biggest thing in the book. And that wouldn't be entirely appropriate. It was my last graphic novel. The only catch there is that I was doing it all digital, and I have been finding that slow. But maybe it's here where I also contemplate whether I switch to mixing it up. Because I do find the mix a little faster. So I still use digital tools, like even with this comic. But I hybrid in various ways. And I think when it comes down to it, I'm still just faster on paper. That's right. We have those seat toppers. That's what that is. I'm trying to remember what I drew there. Okay. Looks like he's wearing sunglasses, which is just not... Oh, for a second there, that was kind of funny. But it's not accurate. He is not wearing sunglasses. There we go. It's a bit better. These students were fun. This wasn't exactly my suggestion. At one point in the class, when I was doing my own studies, I would just pull the paper off and drop it on the floor, which I do in a somewhat neat pile. I mean, it's not tidy. I'm not just throwing it over my shoulder either. But these two and that one started literally just tossing it over their shoulders, which was good. It made me chuckle. It was a little bit theatrical, but that's how fast we're supposed to be drawing. Just go. Fill the page up with a bunch of drawings. Don't waste time fussing with it. They're not important individually. It's about the exercise we're doing, which is a very speed-related sketching exercise. You'll find demos for it on my channel here. That's some spooky music, Michelle. This song's called Ghost, so, you know. Is it Ghost? I think it's Ghost. A Ghost. Called A Ghost. Lostworldsounds also is a name Shell uses to do film soundtracks. So, just FYI. Off camera. How much of that was totally off camera? Quite a bit. Some people hate this angle. Too bad is what you get. You think I'm made of camera angles? I just pull camera angles out of my butt.
part of the aesthetic of this story is a sort of sketchy feel that I've been going for. So I'm intentionally not doing like really slick contours. I'm using a lot of little broken lines and hatches. And then I'll come back in with the brush and beef up bits and pieces and drop some shadows in. And they also use the graphite to carve the space a bit. Classic Breslin guitar. That makes more sense.
Yes. Yes, it does. There we go. The photo. Yeah, okay, this way.
Thank you.
That's the end of the album. Big Bang movie soundtrack now. Oop. Thumb deep. See how long it's been rolling. Oh, it's just about right. 40 minutes. That's a panel. Bunch of old dynamic drawing students and their glorious pile of quick studies. Brief break to shove food in my face, and then I will be back to finish this page.